limit you to their little box. Come on, the world is bigger than your subdivision. Young people, the world is bigger than your street. The world is bigger than United Methodist, AMD, Pentecostal Fire Baptized, Church of God in Christ, and the Seventh-day Adventist Church. Listen, when you stand before God, He's not going to ask you what affiliation you have. He's going to ask you, did you finish? Did you finish? And before you leave here, everything in you, you should listen, pour it into someone else. I'm not even going to go into that area, but don't you understand? Don't you take it to the grave?
Yeah.
Amen.
Mm. Some of you need to be investing in legacy. We need to spend more time with our teenagers and our young people instead of criticizing them. We ought to use it as a teaching moment. If they will hear you, then you need to teach them.
Okay.
Stop limiting yourself to your little circumference. Shut down the voices that don't celebrate you this year.
Amen.
Shut down the voices that don't support you, that don't help you, that don't accept you because they think you're a little different. So what, Jesus was altogether different. He was so different that when he came to the people, do you remember when the woman in the Bible said to him, "Sir, you're correct." She said, yes, the dogs. Call me a dog. I'll be a dog. But your own children take you for granted.
My God.
I know some of y'all don't like that because you think I'm being insulting. No, she said, yes, I know it's not my time. But I have a situation at home. My daughter is grievously vexed. And if you want to flip out a parent, mess with their child. Oh, it's quiet, parent. You flip, they'll flip out over the baby.
Yes, sir.
They're going to let me to school. And they'll call the job and say, listen, I'll come late because something's going on with my child. You want God to flip out? Mess with his child. They think that you are the butt of the joke on the job, but they just don't know.
All right.
The reason why that they can make payroll is because of you. And that's why you've got to know who you are working with and what you're working with. And we don't always know what we're working with until we hit the storm. And then we realize, ooh, God had to be with me because I had no one else to fall back on. See, that's why everybody can't hang with you. And stop trying to get people to hang with you. Okay, I'm going to leave that alone. Stop listening to what people think about you. Tell your neighbor what people think about you. It's none of your business. You spend all this time, what they say, who they say. Listen, if you're not talked about, you're not thought about. Come on here. Every morning you get up, you don't ask the people, should I wear this shirt? Should I wear this denim jacket? Come on here. Tell your neighbor, this is about me and Jesus. This is personal.
About me and Jesus.
If the Lord is smiling on you, then come on here. You only have the King to please.
Right. All right, I like that.
Not his subjects. That's why I have a problem with people they're hating on me.
Come on, say that right there. Come on now.
I said, folk can hate the favor. I said, folk can hate the favor. But that does not, Jeremy, that does not diminish the favor.
Right.
If I'm in touch with the King, what you say on that?
Right, sir.
Oh, yeah, I'm talking to somebody. I want you to know that in these few moments that your life is about to make a big turn. Come on here. You wait till you know what? You you ought to have, you know, like a young guy said to me, I told him what he was going to do, and I said, well, you got this, you know what you're about to do, you got this planned out, everything. He said, yeah, I know what I'm going to do, I know what I've got to do. How many know that this is the year that you can't spend time with critics?
Ha. All right.
Come on here.
All right.
Nothing will get done.
That's right.
You know you're in the business world. You're in the corporate world. You're a preacher. You are a pastor. You know you can't get nothing done with people that just want to talk and waste your time that have nothing. Listen, you want solutions. We can talk about crime all over America. Crime is not just in New Haven. Killing is not just going on in Miami. It's all over.
Yes, yes.
What do y'all want to know about? You sure can't get it solved in church. This is where we come to get empowered. This is where we come to get, we drive up to the gasoline station and we get your high test or whatever you regular gas. Well, I don't know what you use, but I know what I need. Come on, somebody, bring him. And then you go out here and come on, but we're trying to fuel. We don't have no fuel. You have nothing to pour in. You have nothing to give. So if you want to take, then give me something.
All right now.
You know, replenish what you take. That's what's wrong. No, the problem is people walking around unloved, feeling uncared for.